What's up?
Uric acid is a product of nucleotides degradation. The normal level of uric acid in the blood is 0.18-0.48 millimoles per liter or 3-8.2 milligrams per deciliter. To explain the clinical value of uric acid, we have to recall physiology. So when cells die, their inner content is released into the blood, including nucleus. Then nuclear membrane undergo degradation with the release of intracellular content, which is DNA molecule. DNA molecule is composed of purines and pyrimidines. Purines are adenine and guanine. Then adenine and guanine undergo conversion to hypoxanthine, and hypoxanthine undergo oxidation, which is provided by the specific enzyme called xanthine oxidase. As a result, xanthine is produced. Then xanthine again by xanthine oxidase is converted into uric acid, and uric acid is excreted by the kidneys into the urine. But some portion of uric acid can be reabsorbed into the blood. This reabsorption is provided by the uric acid transporter 1. So which factors can cause increase in uric acid level in the blood? The first group of factors is factors that cause increase in uric acid production. First of all, it's myelo- or lymphoproliferative disorders. Because with increasing amount of blood cells, their turnover increase. So the greater amount of DNA molecules will enter into the blood. Thereby the greater amount of uric acid will be produced. Also, it's cytotoxic medication. Because cytotoxic drugs can cause increase in cellular death rate. The greater amount of cells die, the greater is the release of DNA molecules into the blood. Thereby the greater amount of uric acid will be produced. The most common factor that causes increase in uric acid level is intake of food with high concentration of purines. It's alcohol, especially beer, meat and fish. The higher the consumption of purines, the greater will be the production of uric acid. The second group of factors is factors that decrease the excretion of uric acid. The major factor is acute or chronic renal failure. Because with decrease in renal excretion, the greater amount of uric acid will remain in the circulation. And also diuretics, because most of diuretics decrease the secretion of uric acid into the urine. Additional factor is acidosis, because both lactic acidosis and ketoacidosis stimulate uric acid transporter 1. And by this, they increase the reabsorption of uric acid into the blood. The greater amount of uric acid will be reabsorbed, the greater concentration of uric acid will be in the blood. Why uric acid is important for us? It turns out that increase in uric acid can be dangerous. Uric acid is a poor soluble molecule, and because of this, uric acid easily precipitates with formation of uric acid crystals. The signature feature of uric acid crystals is a needle shape. The formation of uric acid crystals in the kidney tubules can cause formation of kidney stones, and the accumulation of uric acid stones in the kidney tubules at some point can cause acute kidney injury. In addition to this, accumulation of uric acid crystals in the joints can cause inflammation of the joints, a condition known as gout. So how to prevent this? Currently, we have a few classes of urate-lowering medications. By far the most popular drugs, it's allopurinol and febuxostat. Allopurinol and febuxostat both inhibit xanthine oxidase enzyme. The lower is the function of xanthine oxidase, the lower is uric acid production. So by this, the amount of uric acid in the blood progressively decreases. The next drug is probenecid. Probenecid inhibits uric acid transporter 1. With inhibition of uric acid transporter, the reabsorption of uric acid decreases. Thereby, the amount of uric acid in the blood begins progressively decrease. Also, we have drug called Rasburicase. Rasburicase is actually an enzyme called urate oxidase. So basically, Rasburicase provides oxidation of uric acid to allantoin. And the reason why allantoin is better than uric acid is because allantoin is much more water-soluble molecule. And the more soluble is the molecule, the lesser is the precipitation rate, and thereby the slower is the rate of crystals formation. And also, the more water-soluble is the molecule, the more rapidly kidneys can excrete it. The additional features that we should know is that rasburicase acts almost immediately, but allopurinol and febuxostat are slow-acting drugs, because it takes time to inhibit the enzyme, which is xanthine oxidase. And because of this, for allopurinol and febuxostat, it takes 1 to 3 days after the intake to make some difference.
Okay. Fine. Yep.
Ciao!
What's that mean?
Ciao.
It's Italian. It means food.